talk now to DILG Undersecretary Jonathan Malaya. USEC, good afternoon. Thank you very much for taking our call.
Yes, Ron, good afternoon, and good afternoon to all that's listening and watching right now.
USEC, I believe you have a clarification of the specific areas which will ban the reopening of businesses.
Yes, we do, because first and foremost, our order last Monday for the mandatory evacuation in all the barangays covered by the 14-kilometer danger zone was based on the PIL-VOX list, or the hazard list of PIL-VOX, wherein the barangays that are susceptible to base surge, ballistic projectiles, and volcanic tsunami were listed. Mm-hmm. Now, in Tagaytay, there are 8 barangays that were identified by PIL-VOX, and those barangays are the only barangays wherein the DILG is insisting that mandatory evacuation be done. Mm-hmm. The other barangays are not covered, and therefore businesses may operate. People do not need to evacuate unless on a voluntary basis. Mm-hmm. So on this basis, we wish to make that clarification.
USEC Malaya, do you have the names of those barangays that will be covered by the ban on the reopening of businesses?
Yes. Those barangays identified by PIL-VOX include Bagong Tubig, Caibagal South Poblacion, Arlica West, Sambong, San Jose, Silang Junction South, Mahakika East, and Tolentino East. Now, when I was talking to PIL-VOX, it was explained to me, to us, that some of these barangays are pretty large. And therefore, we give it to the local government unit to determine if those barangays are really covered in its entirety by the hazard map provided by PIL-VOX. Mm-hmm. No? Mm-hmm. We were told that some of these barangays had areas on the ridge of Tagaytay. Therefore, if they're already there on the ridge portion, on the high area, there will be no need for them to close businesses because they are already a bit far from the possible effects of the Taal Volcano in case there is a hazardous explosion.
Okay. And if any of those businesses in those 8 barangays that are not allowed to reopen businesses still defy those orders, what are the possible penalties for those businesses?
No. As I said, it's going to be on a case-to-case basis. We leave it to the local government unit. Mm-hmm. In this case, the mayor is correct that he is primarily responsible for the safety of his constituents. So for those areas that are in the hazard map, that are really within the 14-kilometer danger zone, we will insist on the local government unit to make sure that the mandatory evacuation is done and that the business establishments are closed. However, in those areas that are not covered by the 14-kilometer danger zone but is still within the barangay mentioned, we leave it to the local government unit to make that necessary decision.
Mm. And I was going to ask for a clarification because it was Congressman Abraham Bumble Tolentino who did raise that under the local government code and a specific Republic Act, that's 101-21, that it's going to be the local government who's going to make that decision. So there will be no competition here, or there will be no confusion on who should be making that call if they are going to allow the businesses to run or not.
That's right. Definitely not. The Department of Interior and Local Government and the LGUs are all partners in responding to this disaster. The Philippine National Police, which is directly under the DILG, has been directed to support the local government units. In fact, the order for a lockdown came from the LGUs, and we fully support that. Mm-hmm. It is just here in the Tagaytay area where there has been some confusion. There was this impression that the closure order referred to the entire city of Tagaytay, when in fact it's not. Right. We defer to the Philippine Institute on Volcanology and Seismology on this. If the PIL-VOX gives us another list wherein there is no more barangay in Tagaytay covered by the hazard map, then we will comply. We are the experts, and we are simply implementing the recommendation coming from the DOST.
We do want to check something with you, Mr. Undersecretary. I don't know if you're tuned into ANC, but we're showing a video right now of the Sky Ranch in Tagaytay. Just over the weekend, It's an amusement park, and it's operating. And we just want to know, would you know if this area is included in those 8 barangays where businesses should not reopen?
Well, specifically as to Sky Ranch, I am not really familiar mm-hmm. with the number of the barangays in Tagaytay. But I would presume that the LGU did its homework, that it looked at the hazard map, and it determined that Sky Ranch was not within the area identified by DVOCS. Because at the end of the day, if they made that decision and allow that this entity to operate, mm-hmm. and there are some casualties or there are negative effects, no, it happens if and when a hazardous explosion happens, then it will be to the account of the LGU and not any more of the DILG.